The thickness analysis command in SOLIDWORKS is one of the most useful tools when designing plastic parts or castings. This command is used to determine the different thicknesses at each point on the part, which helps identify problematic areas that might be too thin or too thick in certain regions. This is done by calculating the thicknesses throughout the entire part and overlaying a color gradient on the model. This cast frame needs to have the thickness analyzed so it's prepared for manufacturing. In this case, I want the design to have thicknesses that fall between 1/8 of an inch and 3/8 of an inch. To begin analyzing the part, I'll enable the thickness analysis command from the Evaluate tab on the Command Manager. The Analysis Parameters group box is used to define the thickness limits. In this case, I'll type 0.125 inches to detect thin regions less than this value. If I enable Show Thick Regions, I can also analyze thick regions as well. I'll enter in a value of 0.375 inches. Make sure Treat Corners as Zero Thickness is checked so that the corners aren't analyzed. And I'll leave the rest of the options at their defaults, including the color settings, and click Calculate to run the thickness analysis. The color gradient's overlaid on the part, and I can look at areas that fall below or beyond the thickness range I defined. I can see that the wall thickness along the back is falling below the bottom limit of the analysis. And there's a spot on the back that's at the upper limit of the thickness analysis. Now that problem areas have been identified, changes can be made, such as increasing the back wall thickness. I'll click the green check to exit the analysis tool and edit the sketch for the feature Boss Wall, which defines the thickness of the back wall. I'll change the thickness from 0.14 to 0.16. And now the part thickness is updated. Now if I return back to the thickness analysis tool and recalculate, much more of the back wall falls within the thickness range, showing that the modification got the part design closer to the final design. From here, further changes could be made to get all wall thicknesses to fall within the defined range.